Fuck it, let's just go.
But I think, so I kind of want to do a little side episode right now.
Yeah.
In which it's called Make Grant Defend Himegoto.
What the fuck is Himegoto?
A really great show.
We got,
is that the show where everybody's cross-dressing?
Yeah.
It's the show where the better question is, who's a dude? Or who's not a dude, rather.
It's reverse or in high school.
Because everyone's a tramp.
Man, I was just talking about Fred.
Yeah, Fred would like this show.
Yeah, Fred from Mystery Inc. loves Fred.
Oh, yeah, he does. He does.
Yeah. But no, I already had the most important part of that character's development spoiled for me, which is apparently in season 2, Daphne sings a song about called Trap of Love.
Oh god.
And Fred's just like, and like it's like this huge like performance, like 3 minute long song on the show, and then Fred's just like, I think I finally get it. And I don't think that he's gonna have a character moment that's better than that. But I'm glad.
That's
like,
amazing. That's amazing. Oh my god.
Yeah.
That's so perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah. Trap of love. Anyway, Himegoto though.
What do you not not approve?
I don't hate it.
Mm-hmm.
It's only 4 minutes long every episode. I can't I can't develop hate that fast, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
It's just shenanigans.
It's just shenanigans.
Yeah, and it's just dicks.
It is dicks. It's a lot of dicks.
It's dicks the anime. Which I don't... Listen, it's okay.
Mm-hmm.
They're adorable dicks.
Yeah.
the point of the show.
Yeah.
But are you willing, in front of God and America, to admit the reason you like it is just because you're a transgender fetishist?
I will just say the reason I enjoy it is because I enjoy cross-dressing, and that's what they do.
Is the reason you enjoy cross-dressing because you're a transgender fetish?
No, it's just fun, right?
It's just fun.
Grant,
it's
just fun.
Why is this fun, Grant? No, this is the side episode now. We had Trap of Love. That's going in something. We can't not have that conversation be off the public record. So we're doing this now. What is the draw in cross-dressing for you, Grant? And perhaps by the extension, much of the anime community who is ostensibly straight men who dress as Miku Hatsune or characters from fucking, I don't know, whatever that space shooter is, that bullet hell shooter with nothing but cute girls in it.
Toho, yeah.
Toho.
I've actually never seen a Toho cosplay in real life.
Yeah, but man, my friend Sean, his younger brother, would do Toho cosplays.
Oh, ballin'.
Yeah, man, yeah. Sure. Why? Are you like Buffalo Bill? You look at a cute girl and like, I want to get in her skin.
No, I think it's mostly just I just legitimately enjoy the concept of kind of being a different person, but taking that to more extreme than just like, and essentially like getting as far away as you can. Because it is fun being someone else for a short period of time. And it's also fun to watch other people's reactions. Even though it's becoming less fun to do that because more people are cool with it. So it isn't as much fun for that.
My transgenderism is not as, like, offensive to people
anymore. Yeah. No, it's depressing. Because there were a surprising
number. I wish everybody could just stay bigoted.
Yeah.
God damn it, man.
About that.
I hate having to wash myself around people. I just want to straight up just call people fags and niggers and shit. Like, I can't.
you know, there were
is that because you're a bigot, Kit?
I can't say so much as a dyke without having to, like, think, man, did I offend somebody? And then, like, getting a mouthful from someone. I don't want to have to say something and then have to get lectured about it or make someone cry. I just want to say offensive shit and everybody high fives and drinks beer.
That's the America I want to live in.
Yeah,
when we're exactly. all together. You envision the America of Clint Eastwood in Gran Torino.
Yeah, dude, I just, you know, I believe
Eastwood,
in my...
He just wants these young Asian boys to be old white men.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ultimately, I mean, the whites are the best. although apparently, anyway, I'm getting off topic here, but this is why I should throw aside.
Yeah,
so anyway, I actually I've entertained the idea. This is terrible. I've related myself to Hitler too many times, but there's some pretty good quotes that I associate with now. But
yeah.
And so to which people have called me out, they say, that's fucked up, Hitler's an evil person. And I'm like, yeah. Can you really call someone an evil person? In one man's eyes, the path of righteousness is the path of evil. But in another man's eyes, that could be just righteousness.
Yeah. And that's why you shouldn't like postmodernism.
Yeah. It's that's why I should like postmodernism, because it says everything's artificial anyway, and that the constructs of good and evil are just, you know, completely made up by people, and so in reality, you know, that doesn't actually, I say in reality, quote-unquote, and the reality that we have constructed, it's all artifice, so, you know, like, I shouldn't really feel bad about the things I do,
yeah,
because... Not only were the actions committed by me that was in the past, and therefore I don't have ownership over them anymore, but also the criminal justice system wouldn't agree. But that's not me. That's me from the past. Arrest me from the past. Don't arrest me from now. Different me. But no. I was entertaining. I was thinking. No, if you eliminate an entire race of people off of the earth, right?
Okay.
And then you told everyone that you did it because they were demons. They were just hiding in human skin. And you just, and like, that's what you went with for generations. Would people eventually believe it?
Probably.
I mean, I wouldn't, probably.
Like,
but
like,
I don't believe in ghosts and shit either. If you believe that,
looking like no, but like you look in picture books and you'll see like people that are like, I don't know, like purple.
Yeah.
And you'll be like, what the fuck are these purple people? And then your dad will be like, oh yeah, there used to be demons, but we got rid of all of them. they walked among us. You know,
I still feel like I disbelieve it as I grew into adulthood because I don't understand. It would be too bizarre that somebody could be intrinsically evil, right?
No, they were just demons. They weren't evil.
Oh. Then why did we kill them?
Because they were demons.
Well, why would you kill a demon, then, if they're not intrinsically evil?
They weren't human.
Yeah, I mean, like, because they're not us. What, are you signing with the Xenos, Maxwell? Are you some kind of heretic?
You know what? I've said too much.
Do you really want to see mankind like defiled that much? The purity of our blood?
I'm just saying the Tau have some good ideas.
And that's why you should kill them and take their ideas. Like, anyway.
But yeah, actually, Grant, that was a super interesting answer to inhabit the skin of another character. Why? So there's many ways to go in a vastly different direction of who you are, though.
Yeah.
So why to kawaii anime girls? Is that just because that's your passion in life?
Yes, and it's also more exciting than just
sexually
like
exciting?
Taking on. No, not that kind of thing. in the it is still regardless. Lightly kind of, not I don't want to say embarrassing, but embarrassing is the only word I could think of in doing it, and it's just that, like, little bit of extra nervousness is fun.
Just the rush of doing something that's taboo.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Is there, yeah. Huh. It's a good answer. It's a good
yeah.
answer. Yeah, that's a good answer that is leaves. I don't know. I'm sorry. I should have started that sentence while I couldn't finish it.
That's a good answer. But no, coming back, I just want to say, you know, I don't want to have to censor myself. I just want to say things that would offend people, and if people not get offended, you know, and just have a great time. Right?
Yeah. Kit was complaining about people in Ohio being offended by everything he said.
Oh, man, it's terrible. I'm like, not everything I said was ethnic slur. No, it was
so you toned yourself down since you've gone up there,
isn't it? Well, I've had to. No, it's just, it's strange, you know, people take offense way easier. Whereas, you know, living in the South before, people were very, very chill. So, you know, you could say, like, that you didn't like a certain thing, or that you didn't agree with a thing, or that you believed a certain way. And people would actually, like honor that and kind of just keep their distance if they didn't believe the same thing as you. But here, like, motherfuckers, quick to scrap. But I mean, like, that also might be because, like, I am also,
You're on a college campus, too.
Yeah, I'm, like, on a college campus with a bunch of, like, rich white people. So.
Yeah. Rich white people are very easily take offense.
Yes.
It's true. And they just have so much white guilt that they're foaming at the mouth.
Yeah.
That's why I'm strong. I have no white guilt.
Ah. Yeah, no, I'm proud of being an oppressor.
I didn't do shit. I don't believe the sins of our fathers.
Exactly.
Yeah.
No, this is perfectly fine by me. But yeah, I don't take any agency. Which, of course, that's a criticism of postmodernism.
Yeah.
Is whenever the Western world, essentially, and Western theory, had this movement, there's a brief moment where they realized that like they were really oppressive and that they were basically making all the Eastern and all like the secondary voices kind of like secondary voices, that they weren't actually be engaging all these other people in conversation, and like conversation being kind of like synonymous with just like actually caring about other people at all instead of just pushing your own agenda. You know, like, we know what's right for you because we're so civilized and understand, like, modern, right?
Yeah.
And so there was this movement in theory where basically everybody in Western theory was going, oh, man, yeah, we are dicks. Like, we did a lot of dickish things, and we've completely, like, eliminated the agency of others. And, you know, we only pride our own voice, which is this, like, academic voice that you can only have by being within this circle. And if you're not inside, like, this loop that we've created, you're just, you know, the subaltern. And then immediately Western theory was like, postmodernism, we don't have to give a shit about that. We're not... we can't be held responsible for that shit.
Well, both of those things are stupid. Because scientific method and rationality is, in fact, the only reliable way to examine reality. So if they're not using that shit, fuck them. They're doing it wrong.
Fucking theory, dude. I have to take so much theory, but the program here is very theory heavy.
Yeah.
So, oh man, yeah. I mean, I have my fucking head full of that those shenanigans.
Sure.
You wanna talk about how literate white people think about the world? I know that shit.
Yeah.
At the same time, as a literate white person, I am really, really sick of all of these non-whites that get to be a part of the community just because of their non-white status. Instead of saying anything interesting, it's just like, oh, well, that's an Indian guy, and we don't have an Indian voice being represented yet, so we have to listen to him.
Yeah. No, I think that's valid.
Yeah.
That's a valid thing to not like. But if anything, the forced inclusion of those people opens
yeah.
those people, yes. Come to my
The forced inclusion of minority voices for the sake of there being minority voices is essentially the discussion people have about, you don't have affirmative action because then everyone's just going to look at any black guy as hire, even if he's hired on his own merits, and just say that's an affirmative action hire.
Yeah. It also, it props up the kind of, was like the entire idea of there being like a duality, I guess, of there being a minority in the first place.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like it's acknowledging that and further supporting it, which pushes us away from, I guess, the ideal that it's trying to ascribe to, which is like, hey, you have a voice now.
Yeah.
But instead it's like, here's your voice, but we're all going to identify it as this other voice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's which kind of like puts it in this other box completely.
It's true.
I'm sorry I went all theory on you guys. I felt a little bit apologetic for being such a racist bastard. So I had to explain where that comes. No, but no, like I said, like there's times where I've said things and immediately felt like I put my foot right in my mouth.
Yeah.
and then I had to like basically deal with, the repercussions of that.
There's this two level thing that goes on. Like if you, sometimes you say something that hurts people, and you want to say you're sorry because you didn't intend to hurt that person, but at a certain point you have to ask them like, when's it fucking okay for me to say anything? If anything can just fucking hurt you.
Yeah.
When does it start becoming your problem?
Yeah. I just want to enter discourse with motherfuckers and then be chill as shit and we can talk about demons.
This is almost tragedy of the commons, right?
Yeah.
And that no one, we were unable to just say who owns the right to talk, right? Or who has more right, the person talking or the person who's offended? If they were just in separate rooms, fucking it wouldn't matter, right?
Yeah.
It's only because that they're near each other that there's a problem.
Right. Yeah, I feel that.
Yeah, it's exactly. So, I don't know. I guess we just got to decide on a rule and then trade bombs with each other until the market clears.
Yeah.
And then you'll be like, here's $30. I'm going to say some racist stuff. You got to be okay with it, though.
You got it. You're going to be all G with that.
Yeah.
I'm going to say some real insensitive shit.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know. It goes. Yeah. Guillotine. Yeah. That's.
Oh wait, I have something germane to the point of the premise of the bit.
Yeah.
Okay. So, if the reason you like to cross dress at cons and stuff is the thrill of the taboo. How does that translate into enjoyment of Himegoto? Which is clearly fetishistic, I will also note. It is exactly a weird S&M fantasy.
You're the one that wanted to watch Dog and Scissors, man.
I know, because I wanted to have the same conversation about Dog and Scissors.
Oh, man, there's a problem with this call.
Yeah? Oh, no.
That's what it says. Oh,
Brent,
no,
it's
fine.
Brent,
yeah, I'm there now. I dropped it
okay.
for a second.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Well, let me ask you again. Himegoto, clearly fetishistic, right?
Yes.
You're willing to recognize that, right?
Yes. Yes.
How does your enjoyment of cross-dressing personally, which apparently has nothing to do with feminization fetishism, translate into enjoyment of Himegoto at that point?
I like watching other people do things that I also enjoy doing.
Yeah? But do you like it more when they're forced to do it by beautiful women?
I don't think I would, but I enjoy them.
I think it's a funny comedy situation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sure.
I mean, like, I watched and enjoyed Orin High School Host Club.
Yeah.
That was a good show.
Well, that show was just an excuse to have homosexual relationships on screen. except they're, but they're not real homosexual relationships. But she's actually a girl.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
That's the whole point of that show.
This homosexuality is wrong, right?
Yeah.
It's a sin.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, that's enough of that.
Alright, I think that's the end of our aside. And that was why I should set aside.
Son of a bitch.
Alright, well, I gotta go.
No. Aw, oh, man. I was talking to a friend, and, he was saying how he was likening people in his life to characters from It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
Oh.
And he decided that I am, in fact, the character Mac. because, you know, I say all of these really offensive things.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't genuinely, you know, mean offense.
You're just too dumb to know what you're saying.
Yeah, I'm just too stupid.
you're like a lovable child who also shaves.
Yeah, like, and I love all people, but I swear to God, I'm straight. You know, all that good shit. Yeah. I might have body dysmorphia. Who knows?
Sure. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
No, that's valid. Sure. man. That's a very that's a very real comment.
Yeah.
Which I appreciate. I like how real we get. Just as friends and also on the show.
Yes.
Yeah. I also like that I can say horrible shit and then you guys are still my friend.
Yeah.
The best. It's like seeing how much of a live, like, bird I can eat in front of you guys until, like, you break, and then you just never do. And then I eat an entire live bird. And it's, like, squealing and shit. And shitting itself in my mouth. I'm just eating it.
We just sit there expressionless watching you do it. Yeah, and then, like, when you're done, our response is just, you done yet?
Well, yeah, like, it's totally cool.
The real secret to that is I'm an existentialist. So I get to decide whether or not that's okay. And I'm like, I don't know. I eat a lot of chicken, so this is fine. This is fine. I think I'm going to bring kid to a hospital, though.
Yeah, probably.
He's many diseases. He's just going to be shitting blood.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
I love you, God.
I love you too, kid.
Yeah, man. Alright, I gotta get out of here. Someone called me during this, so I want to call back.
Oh, okay.
Alright, see you guys.
No, no one called me, because you're the only people who love me. JK, I still have parents.
It would be really fucked up if you said that and Grant was an orphan.
Well, I'm hoping that we have a lot of orphans that are watching the show.
Anyways, yeah, I'm going to pretend I call.
Okay.
Alright.
Alright, bye.
Alright.
The person's house I'm staying at has a dog, and this dog just licked, like, all of my leg, and now my leg smells awful.